Hey guys, so welcome back to our next lesson. In our next lesson, we are going to see how Modify works when we are in AutoCAD. Previously, we've seen how we were using the draw tools here, and we saw how we can use the command line to specify hatch and all that. So let's go to Modify command. In the Modify command, we have this icon. So how do we modify our command? We have copy, we have move, this is our move command. We have copy, we have rotate, and much more. So we are going to start with move. As I said earlier, when you put your cursor there, you can see it's moving. Displacement of an object from one point to another. So when you click on move, it will prompt you to select the object. So when you select the object, you can select multiple objects or one single object. Then you hit your enter key to continue. Look at your command line. And then now it asks you for the base point. The base point is point of reference for the mouse or for the crosshair, as in AutoCAD. So just click near the object you want to move, and then you can see as you move it, you can take it to any location which you want, and then you click where you want to place it. That's how we move. Another command is copy, producing duplicates of the same object. So when you click on copy, you can click on copy, then select the object, hit your enter key. Again, it asks you for the base point. You can just click near the object you want to copy. So we are producing duplicates. As you click, and then you click where you want to place it, you'll see you are producing copies of your object. So that's how we produce duplicates. Once you select the base point, now you can just click and place where you want to take the object. So you can see we have duplicates of the same objects which has been copied. That's how we use copy. Never use Control C or the usual copy that we usually know in other programs. So we have a copy command here. We also have rotate command. When you click on rotate, how you can rotate an object in any direction. So when you click rotate, you can select an object or multiple objects, hit your enter key. And then now it also asks you for the base point, so you can pick a point of reference so you can navigate the rotation using your mouse. You can see I'm moving my mouse, so I can rotate it the way I want, or you can specify the rotation angle. So my rotation angle can be, let me say, 50, as stated in the command. Then you hit enter, so that thing has been rotated to an angle of 50. So when you look at copy, move, rotate command, the procedure is the same because they will ask you for the base point. Yeah. Another important feature we also have here is called mirror. How you can mirror an object. Yes. So to mirror an object, it's just like producing a reflected view of the object which you have mirrored, which you want to mirror. So when you click on the object, select mirror object. Once you select an object, you have to press enter to move to the next stage or the next step as stated on the command line here. So you can specify it. Remember, mirror, you have to specify two points. So we've been asked here to specify the first point of the mirror line. I can click there, my first point. As I click on the second point, you can see the object comes in. So this line acts as your mirror. Then you click on the second point, then you hit your enter key. So the object has been mirrored. You can mirror an object in any direction depending on your mirror reference line. So we can try this again. We can mirror an object, select enter. So I can mirror it in this direction. As you click the first point, so it depends on which side you want to take it to. Then you click on the other point, then you hit enter. So you can see this object has been mirrored. It's just a reflection of objects. Yeah, so those are very commonly commands which you can use to modify an object. Copy, mirror, move. Yeah. Then another tool for modification is called the fillet. The fillet works when you want to produce the rounded corners of an object and also chamfer. So yeah, let's start with the fillet. So when you want to produce rounded corners of an object, go to the fillet. For example, this particular triangle, I want to make sure the corners around have a rounded corner. So when you're doing the fillet, you have to specify the radius because it's something which is rounded. So you'll be asked for the radius. So when you click on fillet, click on the fillet, click on the fillet tool, or you can simply type fillet, then you pick an option for the fillet. So it asks you for the select the first object. Yeah. So before you select the first object, when you check out your command line, you pick the radius command so that you can specify your fillet radius first before you select the object. So click on the radius, or you can just type R, then hit your enter key, then it asks you for the fillet radius. I have a fillet radius of maybe 2.5, then I hit my enter key. So from there, it asks you for the select the first object and then the second object. You can see now we have a fillet of a radius 5. You can also have the fillet. Click on the fillet. First, you pick the radius, do R for radius, and then maybe I want a radius of 1. Then I press enter. So I can now select my first object and the second object. So you can see this corner is also rounded, a rounded corner at a radius of 1. So when you're doing the fillet, the radius you will be provided with. So you only need to specify the radius and then you pick the points, the object which you want to fillet. So it works for all, even this rectangle. I can simply now fillet. Click on the fillet. Just type fillet if it's not working up there, and then you do R. You can pick an R or just come and click on R, then it asks you for the fillet radius. So I do a fillet radius of 3. You hit your enter key. So when you click on this line and this other line, you can see we have a filleted edge. Continue the same radius, just press the enter key to continue. So for fillet, that's how we work with the fillet command. Then the next one here is called the chamfer, when you want to have slanting edges. So for fillet, you have to specify radius. Chamfer, you specify distance. So when you come to chamfer, because chamfer will ask for the two distances. For example, this, you want to slant this edge and this particular edge. So you have to specify two distances. So when you come to the chamfer, or you can simply type chamfer, and type chamfer, you select. So when you check at your command line, you have to pick an option for distance because you're specifying distance. So you can come and click on D or type D as an option, then you press enter. So it asks you for the first chamfer distance, maybe 2, enter, and then it also asks you for the second chamfer distance, also 2, enter. So when you click this and this, you can see how now we bevels that edge, so it's going to be slanting corner. Can also have another chamfer. Just type chamfer or come here and pick the chamfer tool and follow your command prompts. So pick chamfer before you type, select any line, or you do D, enter, hash your enter key. So I need a distance of 3, press enter, and 3, press enter. So click this and this, so you can see how we are producing slanting edges of an object. That's how fillet and chamfer works. So most of our drawing, this is applied when you are doing multiple drawings, and when you are doing mainly mechanical drawings, where you can have a chamfered object, slanting corners, or rounded corners of an object. The next command we have here is called trim. How we can trim an object. Trimming objects works when the object intersect at a point. So I can pick, I can pick a circle, or I can pick a rectangle, or I can pick a line. So you draw it, when you look into this, you will find they are intersecting at a point. So when you have the trim command, it selects the all objects. Trim, with the latest versions, once you've picked on trim, just hit your enter key. Once you click the enter key, now you can simply come and click the side that you want to do away with, and then you can see trims by clicking. See that? By clicking the side you want to do away with. So that has been trimmed. You can also perform another trim again. You can do a circle, or I can just do circle. You can just type a circle. You want to draw a circle at this point. You'll see they are intersecting. So when you have the trim, you hit your enter key, just hit your enter key, that's the procedure. Then you just come and click, click. You can see they are being selected. So you can be trimming objects like that. So make sure it has been, the objects intersect at a particular point. If the object does not intersect, it will not be able to trim. For example, when you click on trim, or just type trim, hit your enter key. When you hit the enter key, because the object is not intersecting, you can see there's a lock showing that that cannot be trimmed. So to do away with this particular line, you just simply come and select, and then you delete. You do the delete key from the keyboard. So that's how trim works. So those are various commands you can use when you are under modifying an object, like move, copy, trim, rotate, fillet, and chamfer. The next one is erase. You can erase an object, you can select AutoCAD allows you to select multiple objects. You can just select, click one, or just select a single object. Then you come to erase. You can see them going, or you can simply click and press your delete key. So delete and erase works like that. Another command which you have under modify, these are the most used commands in AutoCAD under modify. So I want us to continue with another command. It's called offset. If you want to produce parallel copies of an object, we use what we call the offset tool under modify, which is this one here, this icon here. It represents an offset. So when you're doing an offset, you have to specify the distance between the distance between the objects. So I can draw a circle, just type circle. I can draw a circle. That's my circle. I can zoom. I can also have my line. That's my line. So I want to produce round parallel copies of my circle, either inside to the inside or to the outside, either direction. It depends on the orientation of your whatever you have designed. So when you click on offset, just come and click on offset. So first of all, or you can type offset. When you click on offset, it will ask you, the first thing it asks you is for the offset distance. So you need to specify the offset distance. So I need an offset distance of 3. Then you hit your enter key. Once you hit the enter key, it prompts you to move to the next level. You select the object to offset. So when you click, when you come in, you can see the distance between this is 3. Also, when you go out, it also go a distance of 3. So you can see these lines are parallel to each other. I can also do another offset. You can type offset. Or go to the offset here. Then you find offset by clicking. Click on offset. Then you have to specify the distance. The distance you'll be provided with. I need a distance of 0.5. I press enter. So as you click, so it depends whether you're coming in or going out. You can see the parallel circles are being produced at a distance of 0.5, which you have specified. Even a line you can offset. When you click on the offset, yeah. So you need to specify the offset distance as stated in the command line. I need an offset of 1. Yeah, but then you hit your enter key. So when you click, as you go up, you can go up by clicking that single line. Distance of 1. Distance of 1. So as you click, you can go either direction. So you can see we are producers copied object parallel to each other at a specified distance. I think that's good for now. Let's meet next so that we can see how we can move to other commands under modify. Thank you so much.